All right.
Got it? Oh, got okay. It.
Yeah.
Oh, it's filming now.
Well, hi, everybody. We are Walker Road Revelations. We're on a West Coast adventure here. I don't know if we're going to make it past the past California, but so we are at, what's the name of the park?
Creek Park.
Creek Park. We're right near Whittier.
It's La Mirada.
La Mirada Park. So wonderful to be here. SCB with us. We've got our friend Ishitar here. Our brother goes to church here with SCB. Of course, we've got Richard Smith here. Glad to be here today. We're going to play a little music for you. We love you.
So Bob Dylan song. He said you got to serve somebody. Maybe the devil, maybe the Lord, but you got to serve somebody, and you serve them whether you know it or not, or them too. What happens in the kingdom of Jesus Christ is you start serving somebody. Somebody human. Somebody on this planet. And somebody invisible. Somebody we call, Jesus calls Father. Father God. Abba. You might be an addict like his song says. You might be this, you might be that. It don't matter where you're at, it matters where you're headed. Right, wife? We're headed to heaven. But heaven's already headed to us. While we're on earth, heaven is inside us. That's what Jesus is. It's right now. That's the most important thing, aspect of the gospel, is today, now, this moment. It's all you got. You don't know about tomorrow. You might be gone. So let's start serving somebody by getting with Jesus first. Don't serve him first. Get with Jesus first so you know how to serve him. Serve some rotten stuff by yourself. But if you get Jesus in you, you'll serve what? The good food. That spiritual stuff. That secret sauce of heaven that Jesus gave us. He gave it to us free, his teachings, his life.
Praise Jesus.
Yeah, we're here. And while we're here, let's do something about it. You worried about the oceans drying up? You worried about the forest dying and us polluting everything? Get Jesus. Because servants with Jesus will treat this world good.
Jesus.
We'll take care of it. Because we take care of each other. And you, guess what else comes with Jesus? Starts with a W and ends with a D. Wisdom. Oh, M. Sorry. I'm dyslexic. But wisdom. And there's a scripture that says, get wisdom. It's most important of all. And she will promote you. They put a little colorful adjective of a female pronoun there. She will promote you. Wisdom is the greatest thing we could ever get. Because if when you get wisdom, guess what you choose? God's will.
Yeah, praise Jesus.
Yeah, and I don't even know what it is. Stephen, do you know what God's will is? I don't. But I know it's right now, today, doing the best we can. Taking advantage of situations, making the most, maximizing our potential. Doing like this fella right here does. He tells everybody he meets, hello, how you doing? Jesus loves you. And like he said on the way up here, you might not play the guitar, you might not be a good speaker publicly, but you can serve the Lord on a tricycle. On a tricycle. I just heard about a minister riding a tricycle around here. Got run over recently, but he served the Lord for a long time on a tricycle. Made a ministry out of it. How about that?
Praise Jesus!
Yeah, that just shows you. That just tells you. That just verifies for us that this gospel is is an individual thing, and it's a creative thing. And if we collectivize it into some theology that only our group believes, we've dropped the ball. It's much bigger. It's always bigger than you thought. Anything with the Lord is much, much more. And anytime we feel we got it figured out, check yourself before you wreck yourself. Because you ain't got nothing figured out, neither do I. When the grand scheme of things, unless that's what we're here to do, is put a little perspective on things. Put a little perspective on things. I like to say keeping it real. This gospel is real. This power is real. And it has the power to transform lives. It takes the addicts and turns them into evangelists.
Amen.
It takes the autistic and turns them into, don't get mad at me, but geniuses. He don't like that word, but that's what he is. He's a spiritual genius.
It's the anointing in my life, bro.
Yeah. It makes you a spiritual genius. I'm telling you, this gospel, no matter what you do, where you are, you can serve it in carpentry, you can serve it in plumbing, you can serve it in whatever you're doing. You can serve it walking your dog. You can serve the Lord no matter what you're doing. It's a state of mind, a state of being.
Here, watch it behind you.
And really, the news that most people respond to, let me say it like this, the best. You know what works?
Jesus loves you.
Sonship with God. That's what works. When really people believe that they are truly a son of God, that actually works. I know that's easy to look over. That's easy to minimize. That's easy to say, well, preacher, it says right here in my Bible, we got to do this and this. Hey, it's not about a book. It's about the living book, Jesus Christ and you. What are you going to do with that living book with Jesus? He got a mission for you. Everybody's an evangelist in this gospel, or at least they're a minister. How's that word? You may not leave your town and go save the world or nothing, but you're going to save your town. You're going to save where you're at. All the folks you can. I'm not trying to use that word loosely, saved, but help into the kingdom. How about that word? Because you, like I just told them, you might be fertilizing. You might be watering. You might be just sowing a seed sometimes. We're not always reeling them in. Right? Praise God. We're going to play some music today. God is so good. Where are we at?
Lamrata Creek Park
in California. Beautiful California today. What a beautiful, beautiful day. We're going to play some songs and give a good word. Jesus loves you. He's an infinite being. He's more than you ever realized. He's not just some theology about God either. He was a person that lived 2,000 years ago, and he put that eternal blueprint for each human being today to live a spiritual life. At the last analysis, God is spirit. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Praise Jesus.
Hey, Rich, what does my shirt say?
I was one way.
Now I'm a completely
different. And now I'm completely different. And the thing that happened in between was him. We look at God as a thing, but he's really a person.
I was one way, and I am completely different. And Jesus is the reason. There is no doubt about that. No doubt at all. And that song, you got to serve somebody. You're going to serve somebody no matter what you're doing. All right, my butcher says everybody's a minister. Guess what? What does the word minister mean? It means to minister to somebody. You're serving somebody. Can we go out and serve our fellow man today in the smallest possible, cheapest way? $3.99, smile. Smile at somebody today. Somebody's having a bad day, just say hi. Ask them with sincereness in your heart, are you okay? Do you need help? Is there something that what can I do for you? Can I pray with you? I promise you, people are going to say no. Best response, would you pray for me? And most of the time, 99% of the time, these people, they will pray for you. They will pray for you. Happy to do it. They don't want anything for themselves. So we're all servants here. Can we serve today? What's your gift? Is it kindness? Is it maybe baking something for your neighbor? Is it maybe giving that single mom that you know a day off so that you can rest and get some time with Jesus? Is it maybe just keeping some extra water in your car for when you roll up on a homeless person? Hand them some water. Do you sing?
Yeah, I do.
Can you greet people at a door in a church when you go? What can we do today? Can you leave a little note with your tip at a restaurant with a little extra money in it, maybe? Maybe an extra 5 spot on your meal with a note that says, God loves you. And so do we.
Yeah, Jesus
loves
you.
Keep doing the good things. God bless you. Thank you.
Sweeter than Tupelo Honey. I know that's a secular song, but that's okay. I didn't mean to play it, but it came on there and I just rolled with it. And that's how the gospel is sometimes. We can plan all day and he have a different plan. We can plan all year and he'll change us up in a flash. And it may hurt our feelings and crush us, but that's what the gospel does. It makes wine out of us when it crushes us.
Amen. Praise Jesus.
It makes oil out of us when it crushes us.
Praise Jesus. The oil, the anointing.
Actually, when I first heard this song, it made me think of Holy Spirit. She is sweet as honey. I mean, really, is there anything better than that? Spirit come upon you, to give you some confirmation. Yes, ask, seek, knock. God is good today. He will answer you. Let His Spirit fall upon you today. It will be sweet as honey.
That's right. What's that? Here, hold on. There we go.
And you know, another thing in the gospel is mistakes happen all the time. S.C. Beam was just telling me, he comes out here all the time and his stuff don't go as planned. Well, here's what I got to say about that. It hardly ever does. I don't care who you are. It hardly ever does. Let me repeat that. It hardly ever does. It just don't happen much. It's because we got a little brain. Compared to God, He knows so much more. He knows one statement from us might be worth us wrecking our whole day, even though we never caught the statement that helped somebody. Don't grow weary in well doing because of what happens. Who cares about the circumstances? Jesus said, if the world crashes, why should you care? If empires crash, if America the Beautiful crashes to the ground and burns, that's going to suck, okay? But hey, if you love Jesus, your loyalty should not be with a country. There's nothing wrong with loving your country. I'm not saying that, but not more than God. That's what I'm saying. Let me clarify. People hear in different ways. So keep your speech clean as you can when you speak to people. Speak your truth to them. Speak in their language. I'll tell you what to do. Just be like Jesus the best you can. Me and my buddy here was just talking about how Jesus... how he talked to people on the way up through here.
Yeah.
His patterns, his approaches. You know, how did he answer them? Was it kindness? Was it one of them tough love moments? He did both, didn't he? You know, love's not all hugs and kisses and candles and parties.
If there were fishermen, he would use that language.
Yeah, if he, like S.E. Beam says, if you're speaking to fishermen, he'll talk about worms and lures. Nets, hey, fishing stuff, the weather, you know,
fishers of men.
Yeah, so let's use the wisdom God has given us to have that divine approach that Jesus had, that divine response that Jesus has. Those two things, if you can do in your life, it'll change you forever. You can write a book about those two things, the approach of Jesus, the responses of Jesus in our own life. I don't know, reword it or something, but it really is that simple. We live in a complex world. It's time for some simple truths to be proclaimed in simple ways in these days of transition that we live in. Amen.
Facebook, I pray for a lot of people on there. You know, I'm on a lot of prayer sites and different things. On Facebook, whatever you choose to look at is what's going to come up on there, okay? People can say that social media is bad and all that, but I'm on a lot of prayer sites and a lot of spiritual sites and different things. And so on these prayer sites, you know, people are asking for prayer, and so I just keep them simple. I don't throw out this long rhetoric about it. I just put on their prayers and I just say a quick prayer for that person and I move on. And the other day I had this thought to myself. I was like, well, I was wondering if that really works. You know, and God has showed up in my life where I know that prayer works in unbelievable, amazing ways. Sometimes the answer is no. Sometimes the answer is immediate. Sometimes I have to wait a little while. Yeah. But if I trust God in that, I know in the end, the result's going to be the best.
Sometimes a big while.
Yes, sometimes it's a big while. And so on the way here, we were driving along, and I happened to see a sign, and it said prayer changes things. And it was actually on the front of an American flag. So interesting, you were talking about the government there, Rich. But and so I saw that sign, and then I saw it again. And I saw it again for a third time. And on the third time, I knew that God was speaking to me, and he was saying, yes, daughter, prayer changes things. Keep praying. Don't you dare stop. Doesn't matter. Don't stop. Don't stop praying for your loved ones. Don't stop praying for your family. Don't stop praying for your friends. And definitely, definitely don't stop praying for those who you think are your enemy. Because you know what? You need that the most. Those people that Richard talked about, that if somebody's done you wrong and it's jilted you against the kingdom. And
Jesus loves you.
Jesus, and you just keep on going, man. Just keep doing the next right thing. God is good. He will guide you. He will lead you.
Thanks, buddy.
Yes, he will. Hey, are you feeling purposeful today? Are you? Are you lost in this COVID world where there's such a huge mess and 6 foot distance and more masks and more vaccines and this and that and, you know, all the conspiracy theories and everything that goes along with it? What can you do today to make a difference? I promise you, prayer is one thing you can do. You can pray. All right. Talk to God. Get in there with him. That's what he wants. You know, Richard was talking about the will of God, and I've asked that question as well. What is the will of God? Sometimes things, when I'm not ready to see them, they're still elusive, okay? So that I can continue to keep searching, I believe. If I had all of the knowledge and all of the wisdom right off the bat, what would be the point of this journey, right? So what is the will of God? What I've found in my journey and what I've seen in, you know, what I've been shown, two things are the will of God. To love your fellow man and to trust God. Those are the two things. To be thankful in all things, no matter what's going on. That's what the will of God is. To be thankful in all things, no matter what it is. Nowhere does it say we're not going to have trouble. Nowhere does it say we're not going to suffer. We're not going to have issues. Okay, but it does say that God will be with you in that. Talks about the troubled waters. He doesn't say, I'm going to take away the troubled waters. No, he says, I'm going to be with you in the troubled waters. It's like Jesus in the storm, you know. He had sent him out onto the boat, by the way, and then he went off to be alone with Father. There's a story in the Bible that talks about that. He went off to be alone with the Father. He knew there was a storm coming. He sent them out on the boat anyways, didn't he? He sent him out on the boat into the storm. All right. He knew that. There's another story too. Jesus on the boat in a storm. He was taking a nap. He had his pillow. The creator of heaven and earth knew that there was going to be a storm, and he was sleeping with his pillow. Can we follow Jesus when the storms come? Can we rest? And what did he say to the disciples when he got up? They come and woke him up, you know. Come on, get up, get up. He said, oh, what did he say, Rich? Oh, you have little faith? Yes. Stay calm in the storm. So why didn't you trust? Why didn't you trust? Can we trust him no matter what's going on? Man, I'll tell you what, sometimes it's really hard to let go of that stuff. You know, we want to hold on to it. I want to hold on to some things sometimes, and these things that I want to hold on to are usually destructive and not good for me and not good for my fellow man. Resentment, bitterness, shame, regret, remorse, guilt. Come on now, let that stuff go. You are a child of the Most High God. You are blessed and highly favored in the Lord. That's what you want to hold on to. Those are those things that you want to treasure in your heart. That's where the kingdom is, you know. Jesus said, repent, turn and change your thinking. Turn, repent. For the kingdom of heaven is at hand. It's right there. It's right there for you and everybody else. If you're seeking purpose, seek that today. It will fill you up. And
And it'll keep you coming back for more.
Jesus is like a song. Music never runs out, if you didn't know. You can always have a new song. Yeah. When I was little, I asked my daddy, I said, "Did music ever run out, Daddy?" He's like, "Nope." And I was astounded. I was like, "Really?" He said, "Yeah, it just don't run out. You just thought it'll always be new music." That's the way it is with Jesus. There's always some new music with Jesus.
Amen. Praise Jesus.
If we keep venerating the past and going to the primitive stuff all the time, that's okay to find some wisdom, but don't live there. Don't stay there in those mores, in those times. We live today. How are we going to help people today with that stuff? We need new slogans, new things to say, and new fresh ways, like my buddy was saying earlier. I like that. It's so true. And it's just like the birds sing different songs. We all sing a different song, but they're the same song when you follow Jesus, even though they're different songs. Is love the same as hope? No, but they're both from Jesus, right? That's what I mean about these songs we sing with Jesus. They're different. They're unique. But they're spirit. They're from the same source. They're headed to the same source. Their purpose is the same.